I think I just played this guy. He's playing tempo. Hopefully I'll get to play against like some combo decks or some control decks, like some actual bad matchups, so I can show you guys the big weakness behind this deck, because just showing you the strength over and over again isn't really ingenuous. I don't think you should say the in. I think it's just genuous. Genuine. Hum-de-ho. No slith, yes, sliver. He has learned his lesson. Last match, he was like letting my slivers live and stuff, trying to save him for the good one. But they're all kind of the good one. And the best one, he's not able to target, because it has protection from things. So now that I have a hibernation in play, I'm not really allowed to F6 anymore. Always have to be able to respond to a removal spell. Natural flip. Yeah, I was playing the other night, and my opponent went turn 1 Delver, turn 2 Delver, turn 2 natural flip Delver, second Delver, pondered to set up second Delver, turn 3, third Delver of Secrets, and then I killed him on my turn 4. It was sweet. So now he's going to have to use a removal spell on the Gale Rider Sliver if he wants to send in his insect. If he doesn't, I'll just trade the Gale Rider Sliver for his insect and be pretty happy with that. And on my next turn, I have the option of playing Siphon Sliver or Sinew Sliver. So his removal, it just isn't going to go far enough, even though I don't have Crystal in this game. Snapcast Bath Bolt. Targeting... play the Gale Rider, I would imagine. Sinew Sliver, that's weird. I guess that also prevents me from blocking. Yeah, that's worth 2 life. Because, I mean, the bolt could always go up my face. Let's see. I kind of want to just trade with his Snapcaster Mage, eat 3, go to 12. It's kind of awkward. I'm just going to take the 5. And then hopefully we draw our land so we can go double Muscle Sliver. It'd be really helpful to know what his hand is. I had a version of this that was running Jataxian Probe, and they weren't bad. After I started adding more pain lands and stuff to the mana base, though, they got worse and worse. Oh no. I think Jit would be the worst one for us right now. Yeah, which is what he fetches. So I'm just going to play a pile of lords, and then next turn, Siphon Sliver, gain some of this life back. So he has two new unknowns in hand and Jit. So if he goes Jit plus equip, attack, and then I trade with something. Probably one of these sinew slivers. It's awkward because the sinew slivers make my board much better against Jit, like if they're both in play. But getting in 7 damage here is obviously very relevant. In fact, I think I just let him hit me. Like, if he goes equip into insect aberration and attack, then he's just dead. He's just dead on the crackback. Yeah, I'm just gonna attack and deal him positive damage. Try and deny him time that he needs to play and activate that Jit. It's good to keep this looking like a racing situation too, because that makes the Siphon Sliver in our hand more powerful. Yeah, so he can't play and activate. He has to brainstorm. He probably has to kill the Gill Rider and block something, to be honest. If he attacked with the aberration, I would just take 3. No reason to block. So that's probably what he's thinking about right now. Vile's kind of a dead card now, but I'm not worried about it. So I'm going to send my guys in, and then if he has an answer to Gill Rider Sliver, I'll bounce it and replay in my post-combat. And then I'll still have 2 big flyers in play. So maybe he has to target a Sinew Sliver, but that doesn't really do anything for him. But that just gives him the option of trading his insect with, like, Gill Rider or the other Sinew Sliver. Actually, that sounds pretty good. If he goes Bolt 1 Sinew Sliver, untap... Bolt 1, trade with the other, untap, Jit equip. Oh, I guess if he bolts 1, then I just bounce it to my hand, silly me. Yeah, that's a big problem with me sometimes. Like, I think through all the complicated lines, and I'm like, okay, so that's what hibernation means, and blah, 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 blah. And then I when there's a space, like, I try and keep thinking. And sometimes I rethink lines in worse ways than when I went over them initially. Like, I'll go through a whole complicated turn, and I'll, like, rule out a line because of some obvious thing. And when I go back over it, and rethink everything, it's less obvious the second time, because I'm no longer looking at the simple things. I don't know if that's, like, a popular problem that people have or not, but it's one of my biggest issues as a player. Yeah, I mean, so he's going to take 6 and go to 1. That seems fine. He still needs yeah, I think the only line that he wins here is if the last card in his hand is another Swords to Plowshares, and then he rips a land so he can go Jit equip and then plow one of my two guys. And even then, I'll have Vile and Hibernation Sliver going, and Jit won't even necessarily be all that good. Like, he can't really race me anymore, because I just gained 6 life. Like, if he equips here, he's dead on board without another removal spell. The only difference between me blocking and not blocking here is that he would get to keep his 1/2 or not. Like, obviously, he wouldn't be using these counters to kill my Siphon Sliver, so. That's the game! Yay! I played Slivers and he died, yay! So, Maze of Ith is good against Jit, but. Yeah, it's probably good enough to bring in. Cut something that's awkward, like Phantasmal Image or something. Maybe Striking Sliver.